Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's look at the second part of the line by line explanation of the chapter, The 100 Dresses Part 1 from Class 10 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from Classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. So we saw that Maddie was not really interested in teasing Wanda along with Peggy. So let's move on to the next part. Not that she felt sorry for Wanda exactly. Not because she was sorry for her. She would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy hadn't invented the dress game. So Maddie was in it only because of the dress game. So she was not really having any worry, or she did not feel sorry for Wanda actually, just because to have some fun with the dress game only she accompanied Peggy. But suppose Peggy and all others started in on her next. So she was also worried that suppose if she didn't join with Peggy, she might start teasing her as well, because Maddie was also a poor girl. She wasn't as poor as Wanda perhaps, but she was poor. So Maddie was also a poor girl. We know that she wore dresses from somebody else. So she was also poor, but not as poor as Wanda. Of course, she would have more sense than to say that she had 100 dresses. So she says that, but she would never say that she had 100 dresses, just like how Wanda would often say. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda Petronsky. So Maddie thought that Peggy should not be teasing Wanda and she must stop teasing her. Today, even though they had been late to school, Maddie was glad she had not to make fun of Wanda. So today Maddie and Peggy were late to school, but then she was happy that she did not get the chance to make fun of Wanda. She worked her arithmetic problems absentmindedly. 8 times 8, let's see. So she was immersed in doing her mathematics. She wished she had never to write Peggy a note, because she knew she never would have the courage to speak right out to Peggy to say, "Hey Peg, let's stop asking Wanda how many dresses she has." When she finished her arithmetic, she did start a note to Peggy. So Maddie did not like the idea of teasing Wanda. So she wanted to write a note to Peggy saying that let's stop making fun of Wanda. And then she was immersed in her mathematics. But then after finishing her mathematics problem, what did she do? She started to write a note to Peggy in which she would like to mention that let us stop making fun of Wanda. Suddenly she paused and shuddered. So as she was about to write, she stopped and then she became frightened, terribly frightened. She pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Peggy and the girls. Then she imagined that if she would write the note and give it to Peggy, she would be teased instead of Wanda. And she imagined herself standing in the school and other girls surrounding her and making fun of her. Peggy might ask her where she got the dress that she had on, and Maddie would have to say that it was one of Peggy's old ones that Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimmings so no one in room 13 would recognize it. Then she also thought that Peggy would ask her, "Where did you get the dress that you are wearing?" Then she would have to say that it is Peggy's old dress and her mother made her some changes to the clothes by adding some trimmings on it or so. So she did not want all these to happen, so that's why she shuddered and stopped writing. If only Peggy would decide on her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda. And she also wanted very badly that Peggy should stop making fun of Wanda, and she must do it on her own, not by anybody else's words. Oh well, Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. And so what she did, she was not happy with these thoughts, and so she just wanted to get rid of these thoughts about Peggy and about the fun stuff and all that. So what difference did it make? So she thought, how is it going to make a difference if she is going to write the note and give it to Peggy, and if they stop making fun of Wanda, etc. Slowly, Maddie tore into bits the note she had started. So she tore down the note that she was going to write. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best girl liked in the whole room. And then she thought about Peggy. She knew that Peggy was the best girl in school, and she was also her best friend. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. And she also thought that whatever Peggy do is always right. As for Wanda, she was just some girl who lived up on Boggins Heights and stood alone in the schoolyard. And then she also thought about Wanda, thinking that she is just one girl, ordinary girl, who came from Boggins Heights and who was always alone in school. She scarcely ever said anything to anybody. The only time she talked was in the schoolyard about her 100 dresses. So we know that Wanda was a very quiet girl, and the only time she spoke was when anybody asked her about the dresses. She would say that she had 100 dresses. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her dresses, pale blue with colored trimmings. So she remembered Wanda talking about her one of the dresses, which was having pale blue trimmings. Trimmings is nothing but some decorative items added to the clothes. And she also remembered another that was bright, brilliant jungle green with a red sash. Then she also spoke about a green dress which had a red sash. What is a sash? Sash is a piece of cloth, either you wear it along with your dress on your shoulder or maybe around the waist. So you would look like a Christmas tree in that. So the girls would say that wearing a green dress would be like a Christmas tree, wearing a Christmas tree. The girls had said in pretended admiration. Thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. So she was thinking about the dresses that Wanda would always talk about, and then suddenly she just began to wonder about who is going to win the coloring and drawing contest. So there was a contest in the school, drawing and coloring contest, and she was just thinking who is going to win the contest. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys, of designing motorboats. So for girls, the contest was to draw dresses, clothes, and for boys, it was to design motorboats. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the classroom. So Peggy was a good artist, and they all thought that Peggy would win the contest. At least that's what everybody thought. So everybody thought that Peggy would be the winner. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could almost tell who it was. So she was a good artist, and she could draw any picture. She could copy any picture exactly. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners. Then they'd know. The next day it was drizzling. So they were just waiting for the results to be announced. And the next day was the day when the results would be announced. But then the next day it was drizzling. So it was raining the next day. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. So what happened? They went to school. Peggy had brought an umbrella. So with that, they went to school. So naturally, on a day like this, they didn't wait for Wanda Petronsky on the corner of Oliver Street, as the street that far, far away under the railroad tracks and up the hill led to Boggins Heights. So as it was raining, they did not wait for Wanda that day. Anyway, they weren't taking chances on being late today because today was important. And they did not want to waste time because that day was important. What was the day? It was the day that the announcement for the results, the drawing competition results, would be announced. Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Asked Peggy. So Peggy was very curious, and she wanted to know whether the results would be announced by their teacher, Miss Mason, today. Oh, I hope so, the minute we get in, said Maddie. So Maddie told her friend that maybe the teacher will announce today as soon as we enter the class. Of course you will win, Peg. Hope so, said Peggy eagerly. And Maddie also added that Peggy is going to win, and she was also very hopeful about it. The minute they entered the classroom, they stopped short and gasped. So the moment these two girls entered their classroom, they were surprised. They stopped suddenly and they were surprised looking at something. There were drawings all over the room On every ledge and windowsill, dazzling colors and brilliant, lavish designs, all drawn on great sheets of wrapping paper. So why were they surprised? Because inside their classroom, all over, there were beautiful designs on the wall, on the windowsill, and every ledge of the classroom. There must have been 100 of them all lined up. These must be the drawings for the contest. So they were all beautiful contest. At least 100 designs were there, and they knew that these were the designs for the contest. They were, that means these designs were exactly for the drawing competition. Everybody stopped and whistled or murmured admiringly. So everybody was attracted by these drawings. As soon as the class had assembled, Miss Mason announced the winners. So when all the children came in, the teacher also came in, Miss Mason, and she announced the result. Jack Biggles had won for the boys, she said, and his design for an outboard motor was on exhibition in room 12, along with the sketches by all the other boys. So Jack Biggles had won the boys' competition because he had drawn an outboard motor, and it was exhibited in the room number 12. As for the girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most, one girl, and room 13 should be proud of her, this one girl actually drew 100 designs, all different and all beautiful. So what happened? She was announcing the result for the girls, and she said that most of them had drawn only one or two designs, but one girl had drawn about 100 designs, and she said that room 13 is actually proud of this girl. And all those 100 designs were exquisite, that means extremely beautiful. In the opinion of the judges, any one of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. So the teacher also said that the judges who looked at these 100 designs said that each picture is worthy of winning a prize. I am very happy to say that Vanda Petronsky is the winner of the girls' medal. And she announced that the winner of the drawing competition for girls is Vanda Petronsky. Unfortunately, Vanda has been absent from school for some days and is not here to receive the applause that is due to her. So we know that Vanda has not been coming to school for the past 2 or 3 days, and so she was not there to receive the prize. Let us hope that she'll be back tomorrow. Now, class, you may file round the room quietly and look at her exquisite drawings. And so the teacher told everybody to be quiet and go around the classroom and look at all the designs. The children burst into applause, and even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, put their fingers in their mouths and whistle, though they were not interested in the dresses. So all the students went and had a look at the designs, and the girls were really surprised to see such beautiful designs. Though the boys were not much interested, they just had a chance to have some fun inside the room. So look, Peg, whispered Maggie. There's the blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful? So they found the blue dress that she was describing in one of the drawings. Yes, said Peggy. And here is that green one. Boy, I thought I could draw. And Peggy also found the green dress that she had described. And she was surprised because she thought that she was the best artist in the class. But now that Vanda was much better, so she was feeling a little bit, you know, surprised. She wondered that how could she think that she was the best artist in the class. I hope you liked today's video. For more informative videos, do subscribe to My CBSE English Teacher. Like, share, and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.